Hi, today let's take a look at how we can use multi-instruments with Bitwig Studio. A multi-instrument or a multi-timbral instrument is an instrument or sampler that can handle multiple sounds from the same instance. So say that you have a lead, maybe a bass, a keyboard and a drum kit, and you want to handle all these sounds from the same plugin instance. That's when you want to use a multi-timbral instrument or a multi-part instrument. And I hope this video will be helpful to you if you're using Falcon, Kontakt sampler or any other multi-timbral instrument. Let's take the tour. Right, so first let's begin with the Kontakt sampler, and then we're gonna look at the same process using the Falcon plugin. So let's add a new instance of Kontakt, and we can use Kontakt 8 player for this example. And yeah, just load up a few different instruments here. So first I'm gonna go with the Gentleman preset, maybe Levitating Upright. And to add a second instrument to the same instance, we can just press the plus sign here and we get to select a new instrument. Let's go into Albion 1 library and let's go into Albion Orchestra Individual Techniques and maybe load a string short pizzicato. Now we go to the top tab, the View tab, and select Instrument Header so we can see the instrument header for the individual instruments. Let's just increase the volume for the pizzicato. And at the moment we're triggering both of these instruments at the same time, and that's how the Kontakt sampler behaves by default. Kontakt sampler automatically sets to Omni, which means it will automatically receive all the MIDI notes to all the instruments. So we can go to the first instrument, on the top here, the Gentleman, and make sure we press the information panel. And go to MIDI channel and change Omni to port A from host, and select MIDI channel 1. So now the Gentleman piano will only respond to MIDI channel 1. Then we go below to the strings pizzicato and change the MIDI channel Omni to port A and channel 2. Now the MIDI on this first track will only go to the Gentleman. So that's all fine, and now we need a way to trigger this second instrument from another track. So add a new instrument track, right click and select add instrument track, or press command T. Now we need to route this track to send its MIDI data to the first track, to this Kontakt 8 track. So select the instrument 2 track here and go to this output section in the information panel. And we change that to tracks and the Kontakt 8. That means that the notes we'll go to track Kontakt 8. And at the moment this track is set to channel 1, so you need to change this to number 2. So now we're triggering MIDI channel 2. And by all means, if you want to add more instruments, just press the plus sign in the Kontakt sampler and maybe add something else. Maybe add some brass. Again, this will trigger by Omni. That means it will receive all the MIDI channels. So we need to go to this track too, the brass mid, and change the MIDI channel from Omni to MIDI channel 3. And also add a new instrument track, add instrument track, and change the output notes to tracks to the Kontakt track again. And the MIDI channel will be 3. So now we have the third track as our brass track, and this second track is our pizzicato strings. Right, so that's basically how you route different MIDI tracks to individual parts or MIDI channels within the same Kontakt instrument in this case. But to me this is a little bit annoying because it's gonna be a little bit hard to mix this because we have everything on one track. And nowadays I always add a separate Kontakt instance for every track and a separate Falcon instance for every track. But using a single instance of the Kontakt sampler in this case will probably save a little bit of CPU. And yeah, depending on how you want to work and what kind of computer you have, you might want to use a single instance or use a multiple instance on every individual track. Right, so that's the Kontakt sampler. Now let's take a look at how we do the same process for the Falcon sampler. So let's delete this and we're gonna load Falcon. So we'll jump to the browser and let's load something from Mosaic, maybe an ARP. Yeah, let's load the ARP drops. And we're gonna go into the instrument view and yeah, and I'm gonna flip to keyboard mode so we can play this like any other instrument. So next we go into the parts section again of Falcon and we're gonna press the plus sign to add a second part. And for this part maybe add something from pulsation, maybe a bass. And by default, the Falcon instrument actually sets separate MIDI channels for the different parts. We can see here, this is set to A1, which is MIDI port 1. And the second part here, the bass, is set to MIDI channel 2. And yeah, so that works a bit different compared to how the Kontakt sampler automatically sets all these to Omni mode. But you can do that here in Falcon 2, of course. But we're gonna change these to separate MIDI channels. And we're gonna add a third part, maybe a pluck sound. And this is by default set to MIDI channel 3. So let's add some MIDI tracks, add instrument track, and we're gonna set this the output port here for the notes to the track Falcon. And we can actually just duplicate this so we get a third that is already set up with the output channel to note tracks to sent to the Falcon synth. So both of these will send their MIDI data to this top track. But we need to set the second track to the MIDI channel 2 and the third track to MIDI channel 3. So the third one is triggering this pluck sound and then the second track. Sending to the bass and the top one is sending to the drops. Let's just record something fun here. Next, added the bass. And then finally add the third layer with the arpeggio. And as we can see, we can get a little bit of a volume build up when we add this many tracks or sounds to the same instance, but we can always just decrease the master output volume of the Falcon synth or the individual tracks if you want. Another thing to note when you're using multi-timbral instruments is that you lose the control or the ability to control the individual volumes with the faders here, because these are volume controls for the actual tracks. And in this case, all the audio is actually coming from this top layer, so we can only control the master volume, so to speak. But you can always add a MIDI CC7 to control the actual MIDI volume, which will control the part volume. And now, if you want to control a MIDI CC7 for the individual part volume, you can just open the automation lane and expand this view for the automation and add MIDI lane. And make sure you change this to the correct MIDI channel. By default it's set to 1, but we need to change this to MIDI channel 2. And select MIDI CC controller 7 or 11, depending on what you want to automate. And now, if you add some automation here, we will be able to control the part volume here. Yeah, so that's how you set up the Kontakt sampler and the Falcon and like any other multi-timbral instrument to work with the multi-timbral tracks and the sounds in Bitwig Studio. Now, if you want to learn more at Bitwig Studio, you can check out my Bitwig Studio Masterclass or the Bitwig Ambient Mastery course. And I also have a new course called the Bitwig Grid Unlocked course, which focuses on the grid portion of the Bitwig Studio. So check them out at edu.morningdewmedia.com. If you like my content here on YouTube, make sure to also check out my Patreon at patreon.com/gelhain if you want to support these videos and also gain some freebies on the way. Okay, that's all for today. My name is Mattias. See you in the next video. Bye.